If you want to determine your biological age versus your chronological age, the definitive way to accomplish that is with an epigenetic test. Now, I recently evaluated 5 of the top epigenetic test kits that you can do from home. And in today's video, I compare the results. And boy, was I surprised by the data that came back. You'll want to stick around for this. I'm really excited about today's video. I gathered together 5 different epigenetic home test kits and tested myself with each to not only determine my epigenetic age, but also to see how these test kits stacked up against each other and what type of results they returned. Now, I've been working on this video for over 6 months, contacting companies that market epigenetic home testing kits, collecting the kits, getting samples drawn and sending them in for testing, collating the results, contacting people from those companies, and interviewing them. And today's the day that I post the results. So let's jump right in. We all know how old we are chronologically. That's how many trips around the sun that we've made, how many years have passed since we were born. But biological age is a little bit more difficult to determine. Your biological age is a measure of how fast or how slow you're aging. We all know of people who look really young for their age, or really old. There are a number of methods for figuring out your biological age. There are online surveys that you can take. You can do functional tests, or you can enter a variety of blood biomarkers into online calculators that will estimate your biological age. But if you really want to know how well you're aging at the cellular level, tests that measure epigenetic methylation are the most accurate. Back in April, I researched all the companies that I could find that sold epigenetic home test kits, and I wrote to them explaining that I was going to be creating a video based on an evaluation of these kits and asked them if they'd like to participate in the video. At the time, I found 10 companies that were marketing these kits. Now, of those 10, I never heard back from 2, Viome and EpiAging USA. One, AgeRate, was so new that they didn't have a test kit on the market yet, even though they were very enthusiastic about the video. Another, Do Not Age, wrote back to decline, citing the expense of their product as a reason. Now, to be fair, Do Not Age's test kit is one of the most expensive on the market. Another, ProHealth Longevity, originally decided to participate, but then changed their mind. Now, that turned out to be okay, because the test kit that they use is True Diagnostics' True Age Test, and True Diagnostic decided to join in my experiment. Of the 10 companies that I wrote to, 5 decided to take part in my little experiment, and they were BioViva, MyDNAge, Inside Tracker, MyToolbox Genomics, and True Diagnostic. Now, it took me about 2 months to collect all the test kits, and on June 11th of 2021, this summer, I did the collection of all the samples. Now, I did this all at once so that everyone would have identical samples to work with, all collected on the same day at the same time of day. One of the samples was collected at a lab, so the timing of the sample taking was clustered around that lab appointment. At the time of the collection, I was 71.8 years old. The results came back over the next couple of months, with the last result coming in on August the 25th. Now, after I had a chance to take a look at the results, I sent an email to each company requesting an interview with someone who was knowledgeable to go over the results and to get some more info on the tests themselves. All but one, BioViva, granted me an interview. Now, unfortunately, I had technical difficulties with the recording of one of them by Inside Tracker, and I recorded the video, but not the audio. When I was thinking about how I was going to present this information, there were 2 ways that I could go about it. First, I could compare each company's results side by side, one result at a time. For example, I could relay what each of the company's result was for my biological age and then move on to the next result. The problem with doing it that way is that the types of results were all over the place. And that's the first thing that impressed me about the results. While they each provided an epigenetic age, that's about the only thing that they all had in common. They each provided different information. So that left me with presenting each company one at a time, giving a rundown for that company's results, all the results, before moving on to the next company. And I decided to list them in the order of the amount of data that they provided me with. starting with a company that provided the least amount of data and ending with a company that provided the most. Okay, so the first company that I'm going to talk about is BioViva. Now, their test kit listed for $475, and it used a sample of my saliva. It took about 9 weeks to get the test result to come back, and on their website, you can order the tests, and you can also register the test kits. Now, you need to register all these test kits when you receive them so that the lab knows who the sample is from. On the website, you can also get the results. Now, they don't have a mobile app that you can download, but that's not unusual. Only two of the companies that I tested with had mobile apps. The only report that I could download from BioViva was an actual methylation report that lists the value for each of the targets that were tested. And this has about 800 or 900 test results. And honestly, I have no idea how to evaluate that. When I go to my report page on their website, I can see that they tested for two epigenetic clocks, the Horvath clock and the Zhang clock. Now, this is interesting because those two clocks evaluate the results differently. As I understand it, the Horvath clock is more predictive. It doesn't evaluate your biological age so much as it evaluates how fast or slow you're aging. So my result of 67 indicates that I'm aging slower than normal. The Zhang clock is a more accurate assessment of my actual biological age. And BioViva says that my biological age is 61, compared to my chronological age at the time of the test of 71.8. And that's it. That's all the data that BioViva provided. When I wrote asking for an interview, they said they were unavailable and suggested that I submit my questions by email and they would respond. However, since they only provided two pieces of data, I didn't really have any questions. Next up is MyDNAge. Their test kit lists for $299. And I believe that this was the only company that I tested that had either a urine test or a blood test kit. Now, I received the blood test kit, which was very similar to the test kit that I got from True Diagnostic. On MyDNAge's website, you can buy the test kits and you can register them. You can download the reports where you can find your results. Now, interestingly enough, your results aren't available on the website. You have to download your report to get them. Now, one thing I like about this company was their level of communication. Now, this is a very transparent company. They emailed me when they sent me my kit, and they sent me a tracking number. They let me know that I had successfully activated my kit. They let me know that they had received my sample, and then they let me know when my report was ready and emailed me a link to download it. My DNAge's results came back in a little over 5 weeks. Now, those results were also based on Horvath's clock. And as you might expect, it produced the same result as BioViva's Horvath clock. My biological age came in at 67. Now remember, the Horvath clock focuses on how fast you're aging, not on an accurate epigenetic age. All right, so at this time, the only information that MyDNAge gives you is your epigenetic age, which is your chronological age. However, I spoke with Dr. Keith Boer, and he told me that MyDNAge is in the process of upgrading their tests. And in the updated version, they will be providing a lot more data.
It should be ready very soon. So by before the end of this year, and that's going to include some personalized information. So a calculated rate of aging. There's other indexes we're incorporating. So a metabolic index for aging. There's also some genetic information. So there's some enzymes involved in DNA methylation dynamics that haven't shown to impact aging. So we'll measure those.
Okay, now let's talk about Inside Tracker's test kit. They actually have several. And the test kit that they sent me combined their ultimate test kit, which lists for $589, with their inner age test, which lists for $179. So these guys work a little differently. You sign up for a plan, which includes the blood tests. The ultimate plan tests for 43 blood biomarkers, and it has a couple of upgrades. You can choose the DNA Insights, which lists for $249 and which I did not get, and Inner Age, which lists for $179 and is available as an upgrade to the ultimate plan for $99, which I did get. So as I understand it, the kit that I tested was worth about $688. Inside Tracker has both a website and a mobile app, and they both do about the same thing. You can purchase test kits, you can register them, you can read about your results, as well as download your blood work history report. Now, this is the report that lists the results for those 43 blood biomarkers that they test for. Most of their reporting is actually on their website or their mobile app. On either, you can track your progress and you can read about recommendations to improve. This test did require that I go to a lab and have blood drawn by a phlebotomist. They sent the sample to Inside Tracker and I had the results back in 6 days. So they had the best turnaround time by far. Now, as far as the actual results, this is where it starts to get interesting. Inside Tracker is all about creating a plan for you based off of your test results with tips and recommendations for better lifestyle choices like diet, exercise, supplements, and sleep. I did two of their tests and there was a tab for each test. Under the biomarkers tab, they list 51 different blood biomarkers with a rating for how much of a risk there is for each, information about that biomarker, and recommendations for improving the biomarker. The inner age tab is where I got the results from my biological age test, and they put my biological age at 61.8 years, which is pretty much in line with both BioViva's and True Diagnostics test results. They also supplied a breakdown of 18 different biomarkers that they felt contributed to my biological age, with 5 biomarkers slightly adding to my age and 10 biomarkers lowering it, a couple substantially. They also have a progress tab, and I believe that this is for folks who test with them on a regular basis. This will track your progress over time by comparing your current results with previous results. As I mentioned earlier, I had technical difficulties with the recording that I did for Inside Tracker by recording the video, but not the audio. So if you're watching, Michelle, my apologies. Next up, we have My Toolbox Genomics. Now, this test kit lists for $299 and it uses a saliva sample. My Toolbox Genomics is the other company that has both a website and a mobile app. However, on their website, the only thing I could do was to order the test kit. I then had to download the mobile app, and that's where I went to read the results or download any of my reports. This is also where I had to go to register my kit. My Toolbox Genomics took a bit over 10 weeks to return with the results, which made them the longest to analyze my samples. Now, this company is a bit different. First off, they put my biological age at 70, which disagreed substantially with the other tests, so I'm not sure how they came to that conclusion. But they also provided a bunch of other ages, like the age of my eyes, my hearing age, my memory age, and my inflammation score. Here's where they separate substantially from other test kits. They took a really close look at my genome, and they analyzed my genetic tendencies. They looked at how at risk I am for certain conditions, how much I'm likely to benefit from certain supplements, whether or not I'm likely to develop a deficiency, how I'll likely respond or how sensitive I am to certain nutrients, how I'll likely respond to exercise, how well I'll likely respond to injury, and how aging will likely affect my cognition and memory. Now, I'd like to point out right here that this test predicts my genetic tendencies. It does not measure how well I'm currently handling that tendency, what my biomarkers are doing right now. All right, let's dig into the data a little bit. My data for the genome is broken down into two categories, results and insights. Now, to be honest, I don't understand the difference between results and insights. They both seem to represent different facets of a variety of conditions or states that I might be at risk for or benefit from or have a sensitivity to or how I might respond to. I'm just going to dig in right now and show you some of the data, and maybe you can figure it out for yourself. If you tap on the results tab, it'll start out with your summary. Now, this just loads all of your results and you can filter them. For example, right now, I'm looking at all the things that I'm at risk for or might respond poorly to or might be sensitive to. Basically, all my genetic tendencies that are not helping me and that I need to overcome. Next is diet, then health, my physical being, and finally, vitamins. All told, under the results tab, you can get evaluations for 56 different genetic tendencies. All right, let's jump to the insights page. This takes you to a page with a large selection of different aspects of your genetic makeup, like how well you age. Now, it's appropriate that that's first. Your eye health, your gut health, your heart health. Now, if you tap on, let's say, aging, you'll go to the page for that aspect, and you'll notice that the same aspects appear here that were on the last page: anti-aging, eye health, gut health, etc.
Now, it gives you your specific tendency for each trait or condition, whether you're more at risk for that specific genetic tendency or whether you're less at risk or have a stronger benefit or respond better, whatever the parameter. If I click one of them, say physical decline with age, it gives me the genes that are controlling that tendency, some general information, my specific results for that particular tendency, and some recommendations for interventions that could improve that condition. Okay, going back to the previous menu, let's take a look at the other selections. Eye health, gut health, heart health, immunity, injury risk, mental health, muscle health, skin health, sleep, and stress. Under the Insights tab, they evaluated my risk or benefit for 67 different genetic tendencies. One last note. My Toolbox Genomics also provided me with recommendations and tips for creating a genetic action plan, for both improving my diet and for creating an exercise routine based on my genome, and apparently they're going to be coming out with something called lifestyle tracking.
So this kit is more about revealing your genetic tendencies than it is about evaluating the methylation patterns of your epigenome. But this information is really good to have, and it helps a lot in determining my longevity plan, particularly with regard to overcoming some of those tendencies that might accelerate the rate at which I age.
So when you're born, your stage is set. So those are your genetics, but how you choose to act on your stage is up to you. And you can move those curtains around and you can move the furniture and you can give it a whole new look and feel. And someone's stage is going to be very different from somebody else's, even if they're very similar how they originally started, because we all live our lives very similar, very differently. So your genes are not your destiny. And
okay, well, let's talk about the last company to participate in this little experiment of mine, True Diagnostic. Now, this is the True Age test, the same one that ProHealth Longevity uses, one of the companies that declined to join my experiment. Their test kit lists for $375, and it's one of those that uses a small tube filled with blood as a sample. They have a website where they sell kits and register them, but they don't provide any of their results on their website. You have to go to the reports to get those. And boy, there are a lot of reports. These guys use a variety of algorithms to evaluate everything. When my test results came back from True Diagnostic, which took about 3 weeks, they put my biological epigenetic age at 61.18 years, about 10 years younger than my chronological age. Now, this was very close to both Insight Tracker and to BioViva's results.
But yes, you are 100% at decelerated risk for most age-related diseases because you have that 10-year age gap.
Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. Yay.
Yeah, no, I mean, you're probably in the 98th percentile of all people we test, just to be honest. I mean, that is an extremely, extremely good score. Most people don't see that. Even, you know, I myself am a little bit of accelerated aging, so I'm very jealous. That is a great score.
But these guys provided a ton of other information. Now, most of their client base comes to a healthcare provider, and they provide information to be used in prescribing interventions. Because of that fact, they're closely regulated and they aren't allowed to provide a lot of their data directly to the client, but rather they have to go through the healthcare provider. Now, since my healthcare provider is the Veterans Administration, I have to go through a bureaucratic nightmare to get my hands on that information. And although I've been trying to get my hands on that data for over a month, so far I've been unsuccessful. However, True Diagnostics sent me a number of reports, and I'll start with those. First, they sent me a 78-page report titled Reveal Your True Age that rated my risk factors for a number of conditions, as well as listing my epigenetic age. These risks were determined not by my blood work, but by my answers to a lengthy intake survey. So these risks are considered genetic and environmental in nature. They sent me an immune report that broke my epigenetic age down into intrinsic age and extrinsic age. Now, Ryan Smith over at True Diagnostic explained it like this.
And so really intrinsic age, baseline, fundamental process of aging, extrinsic age, really immune system age.
Then they sent me a telomere report and it gave me the lengths of my telomeres. Now, True Diagnostic was the only testing kit that measured my telomere length, which was a pleasant surprise. This report says that my telomere length is 6.68 kilobyte pairs. and it puts me in the 32 percentile. Although other reports that I looked at put a 70-year-old man with telomeres that are 6.68 kilobyte pairs in length in the 90 percentile. Either way, Ryan said that telomeres account for only 2.1% of the aging process, while methylation accounts for 35.5%. They sent me a report on my triglycerides and diabetes risk based on my methylation patterns, and apparently I have a 15% decreased risk of developing type 2 diabetes. The final report that they sent me was titled the Dunedin PoAM Report. Dunedin is a town in New Zealand where they have followed test subjects for over 40 years, since infancy. Using the data collected in this study, scientists have developed an algorithm that calculates a pace of aging, how much you currently age for every passing year. This was the report that Ryan said he loved the most, and here's how it works. Let's say that in your past, you smoked, you drank heavily, and you ate a diet of junk food. And as a result of these poor lifestyle choices, you suffered a lot of cellular damage and it aged a lot. But let's also say that you cleaned up your act years ago and are living a healthy longevity lifestyle now. When you test for your epigenetic age, most of that damage is still there and it will skew your results. But you want to know how well the interventions and strategies are working that you're using right now. The Dunedin algorithm returns what it calls your instantaneous rate of aging, the rate at which you're aging right now, not your accumulated age. Because it gives you this instantaneous rate of aging, it will enable you to quickly determine how effective different aging interventions are in close to real time. If you got tested a month or two ago, you can get tested today to find out how well an intervention that you implemented after you got tested is working. Did this intervention slow down your rate of aging? Or maybe it did nothing, or maybe it accelerated it. The Dunedin report gives you this rate or pace of aging in what they call your PoAM value, which stands for pace of aging in methylation. A value of 1 means that you would age 1 year biologically for every 1 year that you aged chronologically. A value of over 1 means you're aging faster than average, and a value of less than 1 means that you're aging slower. So my PoAM value came in at 0.82, which means that I age a little less than 10 months for every year that passes. Okay, as I mentioned, True Diagnostic also produces reports that because of regulatory restraints, they can only release to your healthcare provider. Now, since I've had no luck in obtaining those reports from the VA, I had Ryan send me samples of those reports just so I could tell what they were and what they reported on. So the first couple of these reports were on smoking and on alcohol consumption. These reports tell you what your risk of disease is based on the methylation changes caused by both smoking and by alcohol consumption. So these reports should come as no surprise to most people, as most people are well aware of whether or not they smoke or consume alcohol in large quantities. The next two reports are on obesity and weight loss. The obesity report looks at methylation patterns on several genes that would make you more or less prone to developing obesity. The weight loss report looks at how well you respond to calorie restriction, whether or not restricting your intake of calories is going to have a large effect on your efforts at weight loss. The final report from True Diagnostic is a detailed methylation report. This report is a list of many of the sites called CPG sites that True Diagnostic evaluates, along with the name of the gene and the beta value for that site. True Diagnostic tests over 900,000 sites, and this report lists about 1,300 of those sites, with those 1,300 being the ones that True Diagnostic feels are the most useful. However, if you'd like to have the scores for all 900,000, simply request them from True Diagnostic, and they'll make that happen. So all in all, the data that I got back from True Diagnostic was great. It was comprehensive, it was detailed, and it provided a lot of clues about how I need to go about creating my longevity plan and what I should focus on in that plan.
I wish people would definitely consider aging more as a disease process in of itself, and because now we have a great way to actually measure it, right? Chronological aging was never quite specific enough to actually yield a lot of intervention. And phenotypic measurements are hard to do across a lot of populations and even within yourself. And so these are ways we can actually quantify the aging process, which means that now you can control and mitigate your own aging process, which decreases your risk of all disease. And I think if there's one thing to understand, it's that.
So this experiment was a real eye-opener for me. First, I'd like to thank everyone that participated. I got a lot more data back than I ever anticipated, and it'll take me a while to sort through all of it. Now, I not only found out what my biological age is compared to my chronological age, but I also found out what genetic tendencies I have, what I'm at risk for, what benefits I'm likely to accrue with different interventions, the lengths of my telomeres, the rate at which I'm currently aging, and most importantly, how my biomarkers are responding right now. Now, this isn't the last that you'll hear about epigenetic testing kits. For one thing, once I've received the reports that can only be delivered to my healthcare provider, I'll be back to provide more on True Diagnostic. I feel like I've barely scratched the surface here. Also, MyDNAge has volunteered to provide a free test kit to one of my viewers, so I'll be having a free giveaway video about them in the future. I'll also be doing videos where I test for cellular senescence, both before and after treatments of senolytics, and another where I test for NAD+, undergoing several strategies to improve my levels of NAD+, and then testing again to see if they worked. So keep watching for those videos. In the fight to defeat the aging process, this information is really valuable. As we move into an age of personalized medicine, the data that this type of testing will impart, along with a minute-by-minute monitoring provided by wearable devices, will yield the type of information that we need to personalize our longevity plan for the highest degree of efficiency and the most benefits. The future is looking bright. Okay, that wraps up another video. You might want to check out this video that I did on testing in general, or sign up here for updates on my upcoming course on an introduction into a longevity lifestyle. That's it for me. I'm out of here. See you next time.